Hello, everybody, and welcome. For those of you joining me for the first time, my name is Evelyn Knight. I am the host of the Childcare Business Coach podcast and the owner of Childcare Business Professionals. And I am actually doing this as a dual purpose. I'm going live on Facebook and I'm also recording a podcast episode. And so for my podcast listeners right now, the quality may not be as good as it usually is since I'm not using my actual podcast equipment. So just so you know that this is actually also a live video as well as a podcast recording. I'm just going to try and tackle this all at once. So I wasn't going to come on live today, but I have been just getting so many messages and phone calls that I figured it would just be easier to talk to you guys all at once instead of just kind of repeating the same thing that I've been saying. My phone is literally just ringing off the hook right now, as well as my messenger is just and texting. So I think this is the quickest way just to talk to everybody. And I just want to reassure everybody, I know what's happening right now is so scary, and we should be scared. But I want to caution everybody to not put fear over facts. We need to make sure that in this situation that we are looking at the facts first. Make sure that the information that you're gathering, the people you're listening to, that it is all fact-based. I've seen some things being posted and spread around Facebook and Instagram that are really just, honestly, it's just kind of ridiculous. So make sure that any of the information, the people you're listening to, question them. Where are they getting the information they're putting out there? What are their sources? Okay, so when I'm putting my information out, I am trying to source it. So if you happen to listen to my podcast episode, I do source in my show notes where I'm getting all of this information from. So just really, really be cautious on what you're hearing and who you're listening to. So just remember, just keep telling yourself, put the facts over the fear, okay? Just really important right now. And make sure you're taking care of yourselves, you guys. Right now, I just see so much obsession on social media and on the, you know, just with the news. So really choose, you've got to make a conscious decision on what you're going to choose to obsess over right now. You're going to really have to just step back and tell yourself, it is Sunday, we're all at home, there's nothing we can do, right? So you might as well be enjoying your family, relaxing, and getting ready for the week, because the week is going to be crazy for us, right? So take care of yourself today. Go for a walk. I know it's getting late, but do what you need to do to take care of yourself. You know, for some of you, have a glass of wine. Ironically, funny story, one of my colleagues was in Italy during all of this. And she actually is working on getting dual residency. And she posted the funniest thing, that in America, here we are like hoarding toilet paper. In Italy, it's wine that they're hoarding. So just to lighten the mood a little bit, I thought that was really cute. But just, you know, be cautious and be aware. I'm not telling you guys not to be afraid. Fear is a good emotion, okay? For those of you guys who don't know my background, my master's degree is in neuropsychology, so I'm always thinking in those psychological terms, but just don't let your fear control you. Fear is there to help us feel safe. It's, well, not to help us feel, but to make us safe, right? When you think of our primitive brain and the people we were during like the caveman days, the fight and flight stages, the fear, that was there to protect us and to help us, right? That we use that. But now, honestly, our lives are so secure that when we do have things like this, we don't know what to do with the fear. So it becomes very hard for us to control. So I'm not telling you to suppress your fear, and I'm not saying to not embrace, but what I am saying is make sure you don't let the fear control you. You don't let this become so overwhelming for you and you're not consuming constantly. Don't feed it. Acknowledge it. Know that it's there. And then use it in a constructive way that will help you, your family, and your childcare businesses. Okay, so just really make that conscious effort to really just take that control. The other thing I want to really address and focus on is one of the reasons I started this business, Childcare Business Professionals, is because I see a huge need in our society for us as childcare professionals to be seen as professionals. What we do is a profession, but a lot of times the public doesn't acknowledge us as a profession. But that is up to us. We have a wonderful opportunity right now that we can establish ourselves and show the world that we are professionals. But that is up to us. And if we get angry and bitter and just really focus on the anger and the bitterness that we feel right now because public schools are closing, but we're asked to stay open, then we can really kind of feed into that persona that has been created for us. So instead, we need to take a stand and be the leaders that we want to be recognized as. We need to be the professionals right now that we want the world to see us as. And we have a great opportunity for that right now. So just keep that in mind as you go to work tomorrow, as we live our lives, that we do have a great opportunity right now to show the world that we are a profession and that we're a profession that they desperately need. I mean, right now, if you're anything like me, I am just getting my parents are messaging me, my staff is messaging me, you guys are messaging me. So we need to step up and help people to feel reassured. So first of all, we need to make sure that we have our fear in check, right? We need to make sure that we're not letting our fear control us so that we can be the professional leaders that we so badly want the world to recognize us as. So just really keep that in mind. So as you go through your days, just remember to be that professional so that when you're asking your families and the world in general to see us as professionals, we are being what we want to be seen as. That is up to us. We have that control right now. So it's kind of not that we want to capitalize on the situation, but now's a good time for us to really show the world that we are professionals. And we can do that if we unite together. We can show the world that we are professionals and we deserve the recognition. And the way we're going to do that is by serving. We're going to show our families that we're there for them, that we are here to help, that we understand, we have compassion, and we are going to lead our centers with compassion, grace, and professionalism. It's really important right now that we focus on that professionalism. So that being said, if you haven't listened to my podcast episode, make sure you listen to it. I'm not going to go over the things that I talked about in there already, but I do talk about the foundational pieces that you guys need to create a strategic plan. Remember, if you want to be seen as a profession and you want to be treated as a professional and acknowledged, then you have to act like it. It is our responsibility. So a professional in this situation would have a plan in place. They would have a strategic plan that they could use. They would have something documented and an absolute if ready for these scenarios, right? And go through the podcast and get it done. If you're one of my members, we are going to be doing this together starting Tuesday. I'm going to help walk you through creating your own professional strategic plan. And this is something that we should all have anyway, you guys. I mean, we should have disaster plans. We should have all of this in place. So this shouldn't only happen in times of absolute disaster. So this is what I'm going to be helping my members produce in their center. I already have mine completed. I have emergency disaster plans. I have all of that. Now we're just going to take what we already have and turn it into a health plan, right? That's specific to what we're seeing with coronavirus. So I see some of my staff members, you guys know that we're going to be doing trainings for each one of you too. And on what the new protocol is going to be, how we're going to go from here, I'm going to actually, my Zoom and Around staff, I'm going to actually do a video for you guys after this one. So just keep in mind, and when you are dealing with your parents and your staff tomorrow, just remember we have an amazing opportunity right now to prove to the world that we are a profession that they can't live without. So just always keep that in the forefront of your mind. And also the other thing I want is just remember to make sure that you're looking at facts over fear. Every time you feel you read something on Facebook and your paranoia starts going, tell yourselves facts over fear, facts over fear. Okay. That being said, the other thing I think is really important is that we start to limit our time on social media and maybe watching the news. Maybe create a schedule for yourself where I will only check my social media from this time to this time. We are becoming so obsessed, but we need to acknowledge that we are choosing this obsession, okay? We are choosing to be obsessed with what is happening right now. And that is just causing our anxiety levels and our stress levels to be out of control. Choose to put limits on that so that you can feel a little bit more in control. This is really hard for us to deal with because as leaders, we like to be in control, but we have no control over the situation. There is no controlling what is happening right now. But that doesn't mean that we can't command what is happening right now. We can take command, we can take charge, and we can lead. So no, we don't have control over what is happening, but you can take command. So just keep that in mind. We can still lead our teams and be in command. So I know it's really difficult because we all feel like we have no control and we want the control, but do what you can, create a plan. It is so much easier on all of us when we have a plan in place. It will just alleviate so much of your anxiety. So just keep that in mind. And I'm looking at my notes, you guys. I just wanted to make sure I don't forget any points. But that's my main thing is just I'm seeing so much fear and frustration. I am planning on hopping on here a lot more this week just so you guys can ask questions. And just as I'm discovering things, I will share it with you guys. I'm going to start a unit section in this page and I will start sharing different resources that I'm using, like my parent letter. How am I responding to parents when they ask me if they have to pay me even though they're not showing up? What are the things I'm going to do in that case? What messages am I sending out to my staff? I will start a unit for that. My strategic plan is only going to my members. And again, we'll be working on that on Tuesday. If any of my members are watching, we will be working on that on Tuesday. And you know what, you guys, it's lonely on this side of the camera. So if you guys want to say hi, let me know you're there. I can see there's a few of you watching, but another thing is I will be bringing you guys some information. I do have my HR expert looking at the new bill that was passed yesterday. And if you didn't know, there was a new bill passed yesterday that does have emergency sick leave. So for us smaller businesses, that was kind of a shock. So I am trying to get I'm that dialed down. So I know exactly before I come to you guys with an explanation of that, I'm waiting for my HR advisor to interpret it and whatnot. And then I'll bring you guys the information and the interpretation of that new law and how that's going to affect us. It's kind of a good thing, though. I know it's a little scary, but it'll keep our economy going. And right now, you know, especially for us owners who went through the last recession, the last thing we want to see is a bad economy again. It's rough, right? But don't worry, you guys, even if we do go into a bad economy, I'm working on stuff. We just need to learn to adapt, you guys. If you've listened to my podcast, I've talked in the past about how when I started my childcare center, it was right at the start of the bad economy. It was actually at the end of the great economy, so we still thought we were in a good economy and going into the bad economy. And then 2 weeks before I was supposed to open my first center, a major flood hit my city that took 20% of the population out, and just it was a nightmare. So it caused huge problems for me in the beginning. And so that being said, there were five of us. There was only, by the time the economy came through, there was only two of us left. And that's because I learned how to adapt, and that's what we may need to learn how to do. So I will help you guys with that. That's, you know, what I'm on a mission to help. And even in this situation, if you're scared for your business, think of ways you can adapt. School's closed. We can take extra children on, right? I'm actually going to talk to some other empty buildings right now to see tomorrow if I can lease some extra space and get an emergency license to help parents out who absolutely have to work. That being said, I'd like to address one other issue I'm seeing. I do see a lot of judgment on Facebook right now and just meanness, and we don't need that right now, you guys. So if you're one who chose to close your center, please don't judge those who aren't closing their center. Everybody has to make what the personal decision that is best for them. I'm working with some amazingly wonderful ladies who are literally living week by week. They cannot afford to close their centers. They cannot afford it. They cannot afford to discount the parents. They have to keep going. So before you jump to judgment, just really think about the perspective of the other person. Not everybody is in a really solid position. The other thing that I'm keeping in mind are my parents. My parents really need to work. I live in a city that is full of hourly employees, and I know a lot of people are really, really scared not to have their job right now. There's more people in the area I'm in. They cannot telecommute. And without childcare, they're afraid they're going to be homeless. So my priority is to serve them right now. That is what I'm really prioritizing. I want to make sure they're taken care of. I'm also trying to think of ways, on the other hand, that I can make sure that my staff feels secure. So I'm putting a plan in place where I'm going to hire a few high schoolers on an emergency basis. I'm going to get them vetted through the state as much as I need to and use them on a substitute basis while schools are shut down. These are kids who are not in the risk, you know, they're not in that risk age range. They're healthy, you know, that age that that is not at risk. And they're normally in school all day. They're home doing nothing right now. So if I get a couple of them fully licensed, you know, ready to go, then I'll have an entire section of substitutes just in case. Right now, I think we really need to realize and think about the fact that we may not be able to hold to the highest quality that we always do. Right now, our priority is just making sure we're caring for the children and that we're keeping the sanitation clean. And let me be clear on that. When I mean like the highest quality, I mean like when it comes to our curriculums, stuff like that. When it comes to like just quality, when it comes to like disinfecting our centers and keeping that we absolutely have to stick on. There's no compromising on that right now. But we may have to be a little bit relaxed on our curriculums right now. We might have to, you know, most of us can't do field trips, different things like that for spring break that's coming. We need to just let that go right now. Those are the kind of things that we just have to just let go of and adapt for now. We will be able to go back to our normal programs, but what we need to be is we need to get out of our normal mindset, shift our thinking, and adapt to what we need to do. And we really, really need to adapt to how we can help our staff through this, because they are the ones who are on the front lines with the children all day, every day. And I know in my state, they just closed down the schools. There's no before and after school programs, but they're also making the teachers work. So the teachers are in a position where, what are they going to do, right? So the demand is so high. These people need to work. So that's when I'm saying, like, I'm looking for a second facility. I'm putting a plan in place even for substitutes, to find substitutes. Is this how I would normally run my center? Absolutely not. You guys, if you've watched my enrollment series, you know that my superpower in my center is my quality. We have very high quality standards. But right now, I'm in a position where I just need to make sure that my staff is taken care of, my center is taken care of, so I will adapt. And that means right now, I'm going to do what I need to do for my business's sake and for my families and for my staff. So just keep that in mind. Look around you. What opportunities are there? How can you fill the gaps that are in your community right now? if you choose to close, that is totally fine, you guys. You, everybody, we need to do what is best for us. And we need not to judge what other people are choosing for their centers. Just so important, you guys. If we, again, I'm going to reiterate, if we want to be acknowledged as professionals, we have to act like professionals. And by judging each other and just really being condescending about what this center is choosing to do and what this center is choosing to do, we're not being professional. If we can't even treat each other kindly, how do we expect our families and the rest of the world to see us as a profession, right? So, you know, that's my biggest soapbox right now, is just we've got a great opportunity to prove to the world that we are professionals. Let's take it. Let's show them what we're made of. Let's show them what we can do. So, done with that rant. Let me see my next thing here. The other thing I really want to think, and again, the psychology brain in me takes over, is really be mindful right now of each individual staff member, because all of us have past traumas, right? Things like this can really trigger trauma. And this is something you need to be mindful for yourself too. Be aware, is this triggering any kind of past trauma you've been through? And it doesn't mean that you've been through a pandemic. It could be some other kind of trauma, right? Like you could live in an area that's highly susceptible to tornadoes, and maybe all the school closures are triggering a trauma that happened to you as a child because your school closed down because of tornadoes. So really just analyze yourself. If you're really stuck in that fear mode, why is that? What trauma is this triggering? And think about your staff. This is going to be so hard on us, you guys, because I know it's so hard to manage staff anyway, right? We can really struggle because I'm sure have any of you guys seen the new bill that came out yesterday? By the way, before I start talking about it, like you guys all know what I'm talking about, just in the comments, let me know if you've seen, but the new emergency sick bill that might actually force all of us to pay sick leave to our staff. So this is what I'm referring to. We really need to show our staff grace right now because they are scared too. And we need to protect our businesses by making sure that if our staff is showing any kind of sign of illness or their children, we have to let them call in, you guys. We cannot give them a hard time about it right now. Otherwise, it can be perceived as discriminatory. And I know for us, we run slim centers, right? We don't have a whole lot of staff. We are so heavily regulated. And that makes it very, very difficult for us when we have multiple call-ins. I know what that means for us. That means that we're going to be in classrooms for the next few weeks, right? And so I just really want to urge you, though, remember you have to protect your centers right now. You don't want to open yourself up to a lawsuit of discrimination of any kind because you're not letting a staff, or even just giving them a hard time. You cannot let your staff feel like they're going to be penalized in any way for calling in right now. We have to really watch that, okay? So just keep that in mind. And just really be mindful. Is your staff, maybe this is triggering a past trauma. I know when I have you guys, when you're first trying to get into Childcare Business Professionals, this group, I have you guys fill out a questionnaire. And one of the things I ask is, what are your biggest pain point? 90% of you say staff, your staff retention. This is the type of thing that happens that will make your staff loyal to you. If you show them the grace that they honestly deserve, you guys, because they're scared too right now. And if you be the boss that makes them feel nurtured and secure, they will stick with you. I guarantee it, you guys. That is why I have such amazing staff retention. My staff knows I have their back, and they know in this situation. And as soon as I'm done with this video, I'm gonna go make a video for them at my center, and I'm gonna do the same kind of thing with them where I'm just gonna go in and reassure them, tell them that I have a plan in place. We're gonna be doing trainings. I'm gonna tell them about my plan for substitute teachers so that they know that their job is secure. I know they're terrified right now too. If I close a center, what are they gonna do? They don't have a job, right? So they are so scared right now. So it's my job to make them feel secure. And it's my job to help them through this, to lead them. I need to be their leader right now more than anything. So just keep that in mind. There might be past traumas they're going through. And they might be scared for their own family. Look at their life situation. An example is like my husband, you guys know that my husband is on dialysis. For those of you who don't know, my husband had a series of strokes between December and January. I am terrified that I could bring something home to him, right? But I can't let that fear control my life. I can't let that stop me from living and running my businesses. So I've put procedures into place for myself where when I get home, I take my clothes off in my garage. I have a set of clothes. So like as I'm coming in, I can change, I wash up, I treat my house like it's a triage center, basically, just to make sure I'm not bringing anything in to him. Look at your staff's personal lives. Are any of them dealing with something like I am? I mean, are they going home to highly stressful situations like this? Maybe they have an elderly parent that they're caring for. Do they have a parent that lives in a nursing home that they cannot even visit right now? One of my best friends can't go see her dad in a nursing home right now because they have the nursing home quarantined to keep the residents safe. So just really acknowledge that stuff. I know we're so stressed right now that we're not really thinking about what is happening to everybody else, but our parents are stressed, our staff is stressed. And again, if we want to be recognized as the professionals, we've got to step up and lead right now. We chose to be leaders in our field. We chose to be owners. We chose to be directors. When you made that choice, you became a leader. And I know that's tough, right? So many of us were teachers and moms. And then we just thought, oh, I'm going to open a childcare center because it's the thing to do, right? And now we're faced with things like this, and suddenly we have to be a leader. And that can be a little bit tough, but we can do it, you guys, and we can show the world that we are the professionals we want to be recognized as. So just keep that in mind. So again, just show your staff grace. Take care of yourself. If you're constantly at a heightened state of anxiety yourself and you're not taking care of yourself, your own needs, you're not going to be able to take care of your staff. Just think of the old adage of being on an airplane. You know, when they ask the mother if the oxygen goes out on the airplane and all the oxygen masks drop, whose mask are you going to put on first? And most moms say, my child's, of course. Well, how are you going to put the oxygen mask on your child if you're suffocating, if you're passed out without oxygen, right? So make sure you're giving yourself time to breathe. Make sure you're taking care of yourself so that you're not just so stressed out that you can't be the leader that you need to be. Even if you're just reserving half an hour a day for yourself, give yourself some time. Give yourself some time to just, I don't know, pray, meditate, have a glass of wine, go for a walk, do some exercise. I know that's my release. I love, when I get really heightened, I love to work out. That helps me out a ton. So just that frustration. We actually just installed a punching bag in my garage. So that's super useful right now, especially. So make sure you're taking care of yourself because you cannot take care of your families and your center if you're not taking care of yourself first. And I'm gonna be putting more information out too that you can share with your parents just to help remind your parents because I know that they're stressed out right now and when parents are stressed out, they do tend to kind of become abusive to us in these situations. So they get short with us, they get rude, they get demanding. So I will be putting some stuff out for you guys that you can share with your parents. My, with everything, awareness. If they're aware of this, usually it helps. I mean, we're always going to get that one or two people that it's just tough to deal with, right? But for the most part, if we make the parents aware, for the most part, they will be good about it. So just, I will be putting some stuff out that you guys can share with your families. I'm going to, again, I'm just going to create a unit that is specifically for COVID-19 in the group. And I'm going to, just so that you guys have resources that you can, and I'll probably just leave them as Word documents. I won't make them into PDFs so you can easily format them to pass out letters to your parents. I've written some different, a ton of different things right now about like how to address the fact that parents still have to pay whether they're there or not, how to address other things like that. One of the questions that was messaged to me that I do want to talk about when it comes to payments is, and this is a really legitimate concern that we have, how are we going to expect parents to pay if they're not working, right? Because if they're not getting a paycheck, well, a couple things. That new bill that Congress just put out yesterday, it will create mandatory sick pay for all. So most of your parents, they will be getting paid their normal salary. So just keep that in mind. There is a clause that I'm unclear about that it may not pertain to businesses with under 50 people. I am not sure about that yet. I was reading the law myself. But before I say anything, I'm getting clarity between my HR specialist and my lawyer. I want them to clarify that for me. So don't hold me to that. I'm not sure about that. So I don't know if that pertains to us. If you have a center that with more than 50 employees, I'm pretty sure it does pertain to you. But if you have one with under, I'm not sure. So I am trying to get clarification. As soon as I have all the clarification on that, I'm going to go live, you guys, and I will explain that bill to you. So I'm just using my resources to make sure that I understand. But back to the payment subject. The other thing you guys can think of, if you're really having a hard time struggling with this, but at the same time, you know that you can't afford to not charge your parents, go through your financials and figure out what is your break-even point. I only will ask Christine, my financial advisor, she has a formula for me and I need her permission before I can share it with you because her formula does not belong to me, it's hers. But I will have her, I know it's something she's willing to share with my members because I pay her a fee. For anyone who is my member, I actually pay Christine a fee to contribute to my membership. So since I'm paying her, I know she won't mind for you guys, but for my non-members, I need to make sure first because I don't pay her for that. So, but basically if you figure out what your break even is and then you know, okay, I break even at 70% tuition. Negotiate and tell parents you'll charge them 70% tuition. Do what you need to do though to survive. That is what I have to say. You know, just figure out what do you need to do to survive so that your business doesn't shut down. There's also a lot of resources coming up that I'm researching. And as I find out more, I will let you guys know. I know SBA is doing some things. A lot of individual states are doing some things. I don't have time to research all the states, but I'm definitely researching what SBA is doing. So when it comes in terms of loans, I know they're doing like a very, very low interest rate loan. And if you guys saw the news today, the Fed's lowered the interest rate between 0 to 2.5%, which is amazing, amazing. I can't even stress. In a couple weeks, I have recorded a podcast episode I'll be releasing with somebody who does SBA loans for childcare providers. And what he told me before this happened was pretty cool. So this is opening some huge doors for us, you guys. So focus on the positive. There's some great things coming for us. But I will be posting on that. As I've gained more information and knowledge, I just don't want to say anything until I'm 100% sure. Talk to the experts, get it all vetted through them, and then I'll bring you guys the information. Is there anything you guys want to ask me today? Go ahead and type in the comments if you have any questions. I'd be happy to answer. I've been getting messages and texts and phone calls all day, so I'm happy to answer anything for you guys now. So, and just again, for my members, Tuesday, we will be creating our strategic plan together. I'm going to post my template tomorrow so you guys can start looking at it and working on it. And then Tuesday when we meet on our membership meeting, we will start working on that. I am bypassing my new, usually Tuesdays I work with brand new owners and people who want to start a childcare center, but I'm just going to focus on all this right now. I don't think anyone minds if we just prioritize this. So we will start coming up with your two strategic plans. And I will be posting that to the unit section on the private membership page. And then on this page, the group page, I will be posting just like the letters to parents and the basic information that I'm putting out there. So if there's no questions, I hope everybody has a great evening. Go and relax, you guys. Take a bath. Do what you need to do tonight. Just be ready, you know, take care of yourself. Do something for yourself. Do something nice for yourself tonight. And then tomorrow, be ready to be the leader that I know everybody can be. Have a great night, everybody.